guys, this is ProudPidgezard and welcome to another episode of Plants vs Zombies. In this episode we're doing the survival pool, which is just your basic survival in the pool. So I don't think I'm going to use peas this time, especially not if I've got the winter melon. Oh, I didn't even have sunflowers. Yeah. There, I'm no need to winter melon this the bit. So, sunflower. Oh, perfect. And my weird 8 kills the first zombie there. So my plan is to get the winter melons. So I got sunflowers all the way down there, 6 sunflowers. Rakes in quite a bit of sun at the end of it, especially when they're twin sunflowers. So guys, let me know in this episode what you think the best map or the best bit of the garden is. Is it daytime pool, nighttime pool, or is it possibly just the original daytime? Personally, I like the roof. In fact, no, I like the pool because I can use spikeweed. I think I'd go with the pool. Pool's quite good. So let me know what these guys do like. Do you like the pool? Maybe he's like it with the fog on it, makes it a bit trickier. But I prefer daytime all the way. Spado. Brains. Do that just save some sun? I know we'll get thousands by the end of it, but it's good to save sun when you can. Twin sunflower. So we're halfway through this, we're hardly any defences, maybe it'll work. So I think I might actually just start planting them. Even just one cabbage pot in every lane, just to hold them off.
Brains.
Twin sunflowers, I want my treat as soon as I can. I'll get the other twin sunflower. Just because as soon as you get them, the better it works out for you, of course. Nearly. Because you get 50 for each one, so these 6 will give me 300 every time they recharge, which is quite a pretty amount of sun. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, money, I like money. I think that's where they'll put the tall nuts. I know I did just lose some money there. Thank you. him. It's gonna leave him. It's actually leaving him. Oh, I got an achievement. Don't pee in the pool. you take you this time. So it's actually, I didn't realise the left, I thought you had to wait to the roll all the way. Obviously not. The zombies are coming. So I'm focusing more on the tall nuts rather than getting the watermelons in. Just in case you're wondering why I'm not using all the watermelons. I will put a melon down there though. No point in putting a kernel pop there if I'm just going to change them very soon. I've all been to a winter melon just to show you what they're like. And that, just look at that. And then it just slows down the rest of them. I'll just put spike weed there to get rid of the answers, cause me a wee bit of bother. So there's me, I've got all my tall nuts. Turned into a melon pulp. But I'll do that one because they'll get frozen eventually. See, to prove that it does do damage all around. Then we need to get them all into winter melons. Plant spikeweed. Pretty much that's the plan. Screen door zombies, that's fine. Don't need any sunflowers, I'm safe enough. So once you're all winter melons and I've got a few spikeweed slash rock, I will probably take the cabbage pulps away and put melon pulps in.
Are coming.
I'm just then slowly, obviously, it takes longer to go over the spike weed slash spike rock, so therefore it will do more damage. See, I thought of everything. Actually, I just thought of that then earlier, but I like to give myself some credit at some point. Money. A bit of pumpkins there first to give them an extra layer of defense. Oh well. No, that anybody will get near me, I don't think. I'll put extra tall nuts down. Three flags completed. Who's here now? Just the same. There we go, sorted. Oh, he's just not happy. Oh, has it just got a mid blink, maybe? I think it did. So that's why I wanted to save up for the Wintermelon, as you can see how good it actually is. And I think the 10 seeds at a time for 80,000 is good buy, but I think you better buy an obvious separate upgrade plant first. I'll save up to put one melon pulse at the back now. Let's do the cabbage pulse. Get some even more damage. If you do them in that way and the top way, top grass at the bottom here, then you'll actually do more damage because they do splash damage. Because you can splash above and below you, if that makes sense. Wintermelons, because if you've already got one, there's no point in having two. Just be wasting an extra £200, do the same damage. So maybe that should do less damage. But they do freeze them, so it kind of evens it out. Alright, so we'll do that. I don't know if it's $670. Two more watermelons, or melon plants to go in. And that'll be as cursed there. Big wave just about to appear. And then except for that, it's just the last watermelon coat. And then I can just put spine rock in there. I do need a pumpkin down the bottom. This is the last flag. Then the bucket heads and the snorkel zombies. That's fine. Nothing will get past me.
The zombies are coming.
Oh, okay. Well, let's just get past the big wave. The Buckethead still take a while with the melon pulps, but they take a while with everything, so I do want to do that. They do die eventually, especially with the spike weed constantly at them. Just out of curiosity, just to prove something. We'll just see how good the spike weed slash spike rock does. Obviously I know they do splash damage. I think of that damage and it just was there. Survival mode. Survival day hard. Now I think that's 10 flags, but it's not 10 days, I think it's just 5 days, but they're extra hard. So, menu achievement. Oh, complete a daytime pool level without using pea shooters of any kind. Never didn't know that. Awesome. So we're slowly but surely getting there. Zen garden, there's nothing in my wee garden today. Well, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. And when you do subscribe, hit the little bell at the top or next to the subscription button, and that gets you the notifications right away. So thank you very much for watching. Proud Pete out. Toodaloo.